welcome to screaming. And another creature feature. Yes, he's come back. After a week's sleep to torment us once more. Once again, it gives me no pleasure whatever to present the frightful Dr. Shock.
Fresh air. Hiya, Bubbles. Hiya, little kid. Here's the star of screaming right here. Right, fellas? You're a little doll. Duck on the bottle, kid. Hi, all you mortals out there. I'm the diabolical Dr. Shock. My little night falls of fright, and welcome to Mad Theater.
Hello there, you wacky little weirdos, and welcome to another flash in the pan episode of Horror Theater.
And salutations, my Saturday celluloid six slicksters, and welcome to another heartwarming episode of Mad Theater. Greetings, my movie mongrels of madness, and welcome to Horror Theater. And good afternoon, my mind-boggling masters of madness, and welcome to another horrendous happening right here on Mad Theater.
It's Saturday afternoon. The eerie face of the devil transforms into a fiery likeness of a macabre, vampirish figure of a man. Above the scratchy organ music can be heard the diabolical laugh of the one and only Dr. Shock. And after that, anything goes. Belly dancers, snake charmers, elephants, clowns, karate experts, even famous celebrities. Anything was possible. I'm Rick Fox. Since December of 1972, it was my pleasure to write, produce, and direct Mad and Horror Theater starring Dr. Shock. We quickly became the best of friends both on screen and off, and collectively produced over 300 shows together. The purpose of this special is not only to look back over the past 10 years of Dr. Shock's shows, but to show Dr. Shock the man. Dr. Shock was born Joseph Zawislak on September the 14th, 1937, right here in Philadelphia. He lived here in Philadelphia all of his life, with the exception of a time in the mid-50s when he entered the Navy. It was during his tour of duty that Joe first became involved in the art of magic. Joe teaming up with a young woman named Sylvia DiNardo. Sylvia assisted Joe with his magic act, and together they performed at many places throughout the Delaware Valley, including the Academy of Music. Joe and Sylvia married in 1958 and took on the stage names of Dr. Alki and Sylvia. In the late 60s, they became the amazing Mr. Joseph and Sylvia. Finally, in 1970, his name changed one more time. He revamped the name which he had used briefly in the late 50s. He once again became Dr. Shock, and Dr. Shock he remained for a decade. His big break came in the early part of 1970 when he was given the opportunity to tape a pilot show for Channel 17. On March 7th, 1970, Dr. Shock's Screamin' was unleashed upon the Delaware Valley for the very first time. Joe Zawislak suffered a fatal heart attack and died during the early morning hours of September 28th, 1979, just 2 weeks after his 42nd birthday. But the story of Dr. Shock is by no means a sad one. Let's go back now to one of his early screaming shows of 1971.
Hello, we're back. And my homemade monster is just about done. Look at that. What I've done now, while you were away, I painted some red lines in the face resembling veins. And I get this by using Stein's stage blood number 4. Don't go using vampire blood because that's dangerous to your skin. As a matter of fact, I do believe they took it off the market. And then get some gauze and wrap your head up, just like you see here, just like you had a headache, right? And a toothache at the same time. And this is a boy with a split personality, right? And I think he look okay. Now you're all set for Halloween. Right? End of April, you're all set for Halloween. Whew. May 1st, I mean, right? You just stay right there, okay? Well, I say goodbye to all my viewers out there. Speak, boy, speak. You're on TV now. You're a star.
After 13 weeks, Channel 17 decided to drop Dr. Shock's contract. Within the next couple of weeks, over 10,000 letters of protest and countless phone calls were received by the station demanding the return of the diabolical doctor. Indeed, he did return and became a weekly habit every Saturday for the next 10 years. Joe was an accomplished magician and was the president of the International Brotherhood of Magicians in 1970. As you'll see by these following clips, he incorporated this magical talent of his into a regular feature of the show.
Widows, how you do? Before you are gonna do another miracle. Observe nothing in a bag. Nothing in a bag. You played a trick on me, a shock, I'm gonna kill you. There I go to my Polish accent. Observe nothing in a bag, nothing in a little crystal cylinder. You observe? Good, I'm glad you pay attention. Observe, I'm gonna cover crystal. Don't take camera off box, because they think I'm gonna do something sneaky, but I'm not gonna do nothing sneaky. Cover box, gonna take a little bag. A yellow silk, for those of you who got color television, watch very closely. You observe silk in a bag? Good. I'm gonna take a magic wand, say a magic word, hokey pokey. Good, you go, good. You see, a silk go from a red bag. You like a trick? Nothing in hand, nothing in a bag, right? And nothing up here.
Good.
Observe, what? Hello, hola. What? Hey, you like? Silk reappear in that crystal tool, cabinet. You like that? I think I'll go down to shower, what that, what check it out, what a movie.
I want you to observe two cylinders, a third cylinder, perfectly empty. Nothing at all inside. Watch. Are you ready for this? One. Two. A magic pass. You like that magic pass? And of course, a piece of rope. A piece of rope. I'm going to do a fantastic rope trick with a piece of rope. Yes, I will. Fantastic rope trick with a piece of rope. Any minute now, I'm going to do this fantastic trick with this piece of rope. Any moment now, gang, just keep your eyes on the magical hands of Dr. Shock. Isn't it pretty? But I want you to watch very closely. I'm going to take the silk and poke it into my left fist. Pay very close attention. I'm only going to show you this one time, all right? Now, after we get the silk poked into the left fist, we say the magic words, alakazoo, alakazam, and lo and behold, the silk has turned to an egg. Did you like that one? You know, how about if I explain it, all right? All you have to do, actually, is to get yourself a hollow plastic egg and cut a hole out, about the size of a quarter, you see. So this goes into the left pocket, place the silk up here, or another pocket, and you pretend to reach for the silk. Oh, here it is. And at the same time, you reach in your pocket, and you palm the egg out, see, with the hole in it. Then you say, watch, gang, I'm going to take the silk and poke the silk into the egg like so. Do this very quickly, because we only have about another 10 seconds to complete the trick. After you get the silk poked into the egg, you say, abracadabra, hocus pocus, and there we have the egg. The silk has vanished. But of course, if you get some little wise kid, it says,
hey, now you did that, you dummy, you got a hole in the egg. You say, yes, but ha-ha.
If that were true, then if I were to break the egg, why do I get a real egg? Notice a little ball. Watch. Into the hand. Take the magic wand, tap my hand, say the magic words, teensy weensy, and lo and behold, look at that. The little ball. I shrunk.
Of course, not every trick always worked.
I want you... Am I on? Thanks, Art. Come here a minute. This is Art Sikowski, one of the guys on the camera. Art, I know you're Polish, but you don't have to go around wearing a babushka all the time. You know what I mean?
No.
No, you can take it off for this, all right? And please, no smoking on the set.
No.
Now, what I want you to do, Art, what I'm going to do, I want you to pay attention. Was that a good cigar?
Yeah.
Nickel cigar, right?
My boss gave it to me.
What I'm going to do, Artie, pay attention. I'm going to tie a knot with these two handkerchiefs, right? Very tightly, right?
Yes.
Right. Hey, Art.
Hi.
Who told you to pull a knot? Oh, here we go again, right? You're really funny, Art. You know that? I use an ordinary deck of cards, as you can see. Can you get a close-up of these cards? We don't want to think we're using a trick deck that they sell on television. 52 in different cards. Billy, you can have a selection of any card. Your choice. All right. Be a nice boy. Show it to the audience out there. Everyone see the card? Very well. Okay, Willie. Place it back in the deck. Let me give a little shuffle. Just like a cell, okay? One more riffle shuffle, just to make sure that the cards are thoroughly shuffled. I will place them in El Cardo's holder. Watch. The amazing El Cardo. Watch. El Cardo, do your stuff, kid. El Cardo, at his will slowly get your card. Come on, baby. Get it up there. Bubs, I'm learning a new trick. Would you want to help me out? I want to practice, all right? Will you do me a favor? Will you find the center of that rope first? Let's see. Find center of rope, and then proceed to cut through center of rope. How'd you make out? Did you find the center? Good. Okay. That's the center of the rope, right? Now we're going to bring this end up through the hole, around here, and down through the hole again. This is what's known as a square in the business. And you take the scissors, sweetheart, all right, and cut right through the ropes. That's it, right there. Ah, it's a girl. A little more. And now we have two pieces of rope tied together with a knot. And now, oh, wait a minute. I've got it now. Let's see. Make the ends even. Cut off. That's it, right there. Come on, girl, you can do better than that. Now we have two pieces of rope the same size. Now we do the same thing. We come up through the center, right? Let's see if we can do this now. Around. I don't think I have enough rope. Let me try it again. This is difficult, you know, guys? Let's see. I think I've got it now. Up through the center. Around. And please don't cut me off now, because this is the end of the trick. All right. Now, being as you were a little handicapped there with your strength, Dr. Shock will show you how to... I really messed that up tonight. Let me see something here, Bubs. It tells me to cut all the ends here, and the rope shall be restored in two pieces.
Dr. Shock wore many hats over the years and played dozens of characters. Here, just a small sample.
Here he is, all the way from the Orient Local, that great samurai swordsman, Mr. Slayshu Samori.
Oh, so, how did you
see
you? What do you like to see me do?
How about demonstrating some of your, whatever it is you do.
Because I am the greatest swordsman in all Japan.
I believe it. Cutting a candle in half. Bet you can't do it.
Wow, gee, you know what?
You missed. You didn't even touch it. You missed completely.
Me, no miss. Onto, please. You like that one?
Hi, kids. It's the old freaky fairy back again, here with another fermented fairy tale.
Come on in here, Rip. Come on in here.
Yeah. I knew I was going to get that.
Yeah.
Is that a cowboy?
Saddle the Western saddle backwards.
I see. And did you like it?
Well, it did open my eyes, it might.
Hey, listen, what you got? It's the food man.
We're not going to use the hot dogs today. You know what a sergeant is, don't you? That's a mother-in-law with stripes. La, 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 la. As a matter of fact, my mother-in-law had a very early American face. She looked like George Washington. La, 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 la. Where even keeping yourself?
Safari.
A safari?
Hey, which word did you miss, dummy?
It's time for Hackshot News with Delaware Valley's number 86 news team. And now, here's Larry.
Keep that camera off my face, you missile. President-elect Jimmy Carter announced today that since he's been elected, the entire country seems to be going south. J.C. also announced that things will be much better with the economy when he takes office. And to prove this, he's planned a peanut in every pot.
Well, what could you possibly expect to kill with a plastic boomerang?
Oh, good thing you asked me. Good luck, couldn't even know what he. See what I can do.
You got me.
A kid coming up with this cock a buck.
Plastic bird? That's amazing.
Joe was an avid sportsman and loved camping. But even with making hundreds of public appearances over the years and doing a weekly show, he still found the time for various charities. He appeared at celebrity golf tournaments with Mike Douglas, Joey Bishop, and Bob Hope, just to name a few. He visited children at numerous hospitals throughout the city, and for 3 years in a row, acted as the carnival's chairman for the Philadelphia chapter of muscular dystrophy. In this 1977 photo, Joe demonstrates to Jerry Lewis his knack for turning $1 into many dollars for MD. Did the good doctor make numerous appearances with famous celebrities, but sometimes the celebrities drop by to make an appearance with him.
Right now, gang, I want you to take a look at one of the highlights of the day's movie, House of Frankenstein. Watch.
I always thought they shouldn't have shown the whole skeleton, because he should have had clothes on, robes, which was buried. The live Dracula, he's fully dressed. Right. So where were the clothes?
Kind of difficult to throw away clothes.
I want you to notice something here. This man hadn't drawn a breath for 25 or 30 years. Mm. He'd been the undead in the coffin. Mm-hmm. Notice I open my mouth and gasp. Take the first breath.
Right.
This is my idea, not the director's, huh?
From your hand.
Were there any roles that were offered to you that you turned down?
Oh, yes, I turned down the monster in Frankenstein. They sent me out to makeup, and the makeup men started to mix up a bowl of plaster, and I, being a sculptor, knew right away what he was up to. He was going to take a life mask. So I said, what is this? What do I play? He said, you play a monster. Well, I was very proud of the fact I was a stage actor, and I said, well, I have any dialogue? I said, this is not for me.
The monster you were referring to was the Frankenstein monster, the monster of Boris Karloff.
Finally, Karloff took it.
Right.
And made him a star.
Fantastic makeup job, I must admit.
Yes, it was, and what a performance he gave.
And now, gang, the moment you've been waiting for. What do you think Lassie would be so kind as to come out here and do a few tricks for us?
Come on, Lassie. That's my baby. Yeah,
look at this beautiful girl.
All right, come on.
What is she going to do for us today?
Well, Lassie's favorite actor is the Lone Ranger's horse. Come here, Lassie. Come here. Hi-ho, Silver. Come on. Hi-ho. Hi-ho. Hi-ho, Silver. Hi-ho. That's good. Oh, baby. You will speak. Make a bow. Okay. That's good.
Now you give her a little treat, right?
I always give her a treat after.
You're doing such a good job.
That's it.
There you go. Will she come to me? She won't.
Sure.
She's not afraid of me, is she?
No. One of them.
Hiya, sweetheart.
Give him a kiss.
You ever kiss her, Shocky? Huh? The dog loves me. I told you the show was going to the dogs, didn't I?
George, if you ever need someone on the hee-haw to do some magic, will you give me a call, please?
I'm
really not that bad, George, you know? If I put my mind to it, you know? But look at it.
You're not that bad.
Observe. Look in the bag.
Yeah, nothing
Watch.
In the bag.
Look at that.
Mm-hmm.
Even if I turn the bag inside out, right, then we'll zip the old bag up, right? Look at this. Nothing at all, George, right? You want to take a slap? Go ahead. Take a slap. Take a slap.
Okay, slap the old bag.
That's good.
I hit that little bird in there.
No, you. You were. George. Look at that. You were almost right, George.
See? It's a baby.
Come on. That's it. Look at that.
Oh, an artificial
Did
bird.
You like that?
Isn't that wonderful?
Isn't he beautiful?
Hi there. What? How would you like to go to Thanksgiving with me?
It was evident that Dr. Shock's all-time favorite guest was the masterful Harry Blackstone, Jr.
Harry, take out the handkerchief, fully restore, hold it up, and show everyone that your handkerchief is...
Just a minute.
Haven't been on a strip for so long. Ah, yes! Place back in bag. Place it back in the bag, Harry. You don't need more magic words, and the handkerchief is there. Quickly, no. Harry, quickly!
Okay.
You'll make me look
Dr.
bad
Shock.
Here. What happened to the music fair? You only... Hey, Harry, take the handkerchief and hold it up and show it fully restored. This is a fantastic trick, eh?
It really... What's in there?
Nothing. Did I do it?
You did.
I knew I would.
On almost any given Saturday, the doctor was asked for his professional advice on many crucial matters.
Once again, a little effect with
Doc,
three little balls,
Doc,
a
Doc,
blue, a white.
You gotta help me, Doc.
And
Doc, you gotta help me.
Where does it say you'd come in and pick up my props?
You dummy, now what's the problem now?
My
Spit
wife,
it out.
My wife's a real dummy, Doc.
Who cares? I know she's a dummy. Now, what's the matter with that?
What's the matter with being a dummy?
Huh?
She thinks a Big Mac's a hood from Chicago.
Thinks a Big Mac's a hood from Chicago.
Yeah.
Where does it say you hit Shocky?
You know, a piece of rope in the hands of Dr. Shock becomes a miracle.
Doc, you gotta help me. I'm burning up.
You're burning up?
Yeah.
Can you put a little more feeling into it? I'm burning up.
I'm burning up.
That's... How's that?
Thanks.
Needed that.
You need... Come on. Close. I'm gonna... I'm gonna get a matchbox. Are you ready? Come on in.
Doctor.
Yes.
I'm gonna die.
You're gonna die.
I'm gonna die.
You're gonna die.
I'm gonna...
Have any money? Do you have any money?
I don't have any
money. Doc. No. Please. 1,000 or 2,000.
I can't.
Right. Right, sir. Just a thing here. Take care of it. Just to pay hundreds and hundreds of doctors.
Arthritis.
Hi, doll. I brought your Valentine's present.
Oh, that's awful thoughtful of you, sweetheart. Did you make this all yourself?
No, actually, I had inspiration for it.
Oh. Oh, and sweet.
Oh, yeah, there it is.
Oh. Yeah, I've been fooling around with this thing here. I wonder...
Doc, you gotta help me. Honest, you gotta help me.
What seems to be the problem?
My wife just took a dip in a pool. I don't even know who he was.
Come on. Just 1, 2, 3.
Doc, you gotta help me.
What seems to be the problem?
It's my wife.
What's the matter with her?
She thinks I'm a tall boy. She never had exact change.
You mean she never had exact change, you imbecile? Get out of here.
Joe Zawislak was a family man. He and Sylvia were blessed over the years with 5 children. Debbie, Diana, Denise, Joe Jr., and Doreen. Of course, you probably remember her better as Bubbles. Week after week, Bubbles would open the show with her dad. She was always smiling and always as pretty as a picture. But the nicest thing was, we got to see her grow up right before our eyes.
I believe the children are our future. Teach them well and let them lead the way. Show them all the beauty they possess inside. Give them a sense of pride to make it easier. Let the children's laughter remind us how we used to be. Everybody's searching for a hero. I never found anyone who fulfilled my need. A lonely place yourself is the greatest love of all. I believe the children are our future. Teach them well and let them lead the way. Show them all the beauty they possess in time. Give them a say.
A collection of comedy bits from over the years that truly emphasize what Dr. Shock was all about.
I had a piece of fang mail here. What in the world? Wait a minute. Maybe it's in the coffin. I'm always putting things in the coffin. Gah! What is this?
They put it down with a big bite on it.
Will you talk English? Will you talk English? What?
But where am I?
Who are you?
Oh, who am I?
Who are you?
I am Count Dracula.
Oh, no, you're not. I know Count Dracula. He's a very good friend of mine.
Ah, then do you believe the Count of Monte Cristo?
No, you're not the Count of Monte Cristo either, because I know who the Count of Monte Cristo is and what he looks like.
Then perhaps I am Count Basie.
Oh, here's a letter from my very good friend, Linda Lovely. It says, Dear Dr. Shock, I enjoyed your movie last week, but you were a little hard to swallow. Hey, gang, Dr. Shock, I thought you'd like to know some of the movies that are coming up in the near distant future, right? Are you ready for this? I can file a little list. The list. Hey, I got 30 seconds for the bit. You give me 10 seconds of fanfare. Let's get on with the movies. I have a cookbook here somewhere. Yes, indeed. Here's the old cookbook.
You are a lucky and fortunate person. You are about to embark on a tasty little voyage in the vast wilderness of ecstasy.
I thought I was going to bake a cake.
Step number one, sift the eggs, beat the flour, take a shot of whiskey. Now blend a quarter pound of butter with a half ounce of vanilla, set the oven at 12 degrees centigrade, pull down the window shades and take another shot of whiskey.
You're going too fast, Irma, you know that? Oh, sift the eggs, beat the flour.
Whipped the potatoes, cracked another egg, add three parts of water to each part you like watered. Watered your plants, add the coconut, turn down the rheostat, and take another shot of whiskey.
Ah, that's what I'm doing, that's what I'm doing, boy, that's what I'm doing.
What's next? Blend the flour, pistachio nuts, salt, tanna leaves, turn your oven off. Change your clothes, beat your mixture, take another shot of whiskey, take another shot of whiskey, take another shot of whiskey. Congratulations, you are now too drunk to care about the cake.
There's the chic from Manioc, right? That's it. You got it now, Jer. That's it. Beautiful. Beautiful. Now, how about give us another, step. That's it. Lovely. Lovely. Hey, Jer, that wasn't in the...
I see you found my elephant.
Is this your elephant?
Yes, that's my elephant. Thank you very much.
Frith, she don't want the bottle anymore.
She's not too hungry today, I guess.
Hey, let me ask you a question. How much food does the animal eat?
Oh, about $32 a day.
$32 just to feed the elephant?
Oh, no, just for me. $4.95 for the elephant.
I want you to show all my fans out there a little demonstration of karate.
I break a block. Break a block.
You're not going to break my head, pal.
No, I break a block.
Oh,
you got a block?
A block of what?
Hey, you got a block. I break a block.
A block of what?
A block of wood.
Block of wood.
You got a block.
I just happen to have a block of wood.
Now, that's a block.
What do I do with it?
Concentrate, close eyes, concentrate very much. Hold up like that.
Right here.
I'll be right.
Okay.
Close eyes, concentrate, meditate. Eyes closed?
Yes, yeah.
Yeah!
Hey, that was fantastic.
Come on.
Look at that. That was amazing.
I remember one day, one of the great thrills of my life, was seeing the great Cochise riding on the prairie.
Cochise?
Yes. I call out to him. I say, Cochise. Cochise, Cochise.
And what him say? What he say?
Him, I thought you'd never ask. Him say, bless you, bless you, bless you. Oh, him very funny fellow.
Very funny, that's funny. Hi, gang, I'm going to explain once again. You get a doctor
shot. I told my mommy on you!
What do you mean you told your mom?
Yeah, hitting me last week with the pie and the face and the water and the hammer.
Wait a minute, please. Your mother...
Hey, get up!
What's
my mommy.
Well, your mommy
you're nasty.
Mommy.
I want to say one thing, you nasty, nasty person. Tell him, Mom.
What do you mean,
oh,
nasty?
Shut up.
What do you mean I'm nasty?
Every time he comes on my little boy, you get water.
Yeah.
See that?
Yeah.
I don't like that.
What do you mean?
Hey, wait a minute.
Don't you like me hitting your boy in the face with a pie?
What? I don't like that.
What do you
way.
What's the matter? Mrs. Shearer, you mean to tell me you don't like me doing that to your boy? Mrs. Shower, control yourself. Wait. It's not funny. What do you mean it's not funny?
We're going home.
Mrs. Shower, I have one thing to tell you. Now get out of here. Let's get back to the movie now. Get these weirdos out of here, will you?
My customer, my first customer. What can I do for you, son?
What do you want for eggs?
What do I want for eggs? We got eggs special this week. 60 cents a dozen, and I also got cracked ones for 20 cents a dozen.
Crack me a dozen.
Crack you a dozen. How about a chicken that lays hot dogs? Yeah. Boing. You don't like them?
Yeah.
Chickens don't like hot dogs, huh?
No.
You want cracked eggs?
All right.
30 cents a dozen, huh? Out of here now. Now, where was I?
You better go fishing while the fish are still biting. You understand? Go ahead.
Yes, you're right. Somewhere out there, there's a fish with my name on it.
Hey, what's your name?
Reginald von Farquharth Pennington III.
Hey, you better get yourself a bigger hook.
Oh,
get out of here now.
Just watch what happens when a bug meets up with D-convict bug spray and underarm deodorant. Okay, guys, cue the bug. There he is, folks. Look at that big old nasty bug. Now watch how effective this wonderful stuff is. Now, isn't that wonderful? See that? That is a pig in the luau.
I'm going to show you another miracle with a hat. Nothing inside a hat. Watch this. Don't look, boy. Don't look now. Watch. Into the hat with the water. Say the magic words and the water will vanish. Abracadabra, the water vanished. See no more water. Ha, ha, ha. You got it. Well, did you ever have any streakers back in the 1800s?
Oh, yes. Many moons ago.
Many moons ago?
Yes. Matter of fact, me remember one streaker especially well.
No kidding.
Him old chief Crazy Bottom.
Crazy Bottom?
Yes. Oh. Every time him run past village, we know another moon had passed. What's the largest animal you've ever shot with your bow and arrow?
Oh, come on. Come away. Ratsky.
A rat?
What?
All right now, wild man. easy, boy. Wild man will give us a demonstration in shooting an apple off one of our volunteers' heads. Is that right? You go over there.
And Charlie O'Gara, he's been kind enough to volunteer. Would you come in here, Charlie? And that's fine. And Charlie's going to stare with the apple. And Wild Man will now attempt to shoot the apple off of Charlie's head. Go. Oh, I'm, geez. So, so close. My goodness gracious. Charlie's just as steady as a rock there, folks. Can't believe it. Here goes another. Oh, my goodness. So close again. Well, Charlie, thank you anyway. Wild Man, I would like to thank you. We'd like to thank you. Now, you understand, even though you didn't get the... Calm down. Calm down. Even though you didn't shoot the... Calm down. Wild Man still always gets what he's after. But tell me, Wild Man, if
I want to quit.
Wait till I ask the question. Awesome. Then tell me. If all else fails, if you swallow your darts, if your string breaks on your bow and arrow, if your boomerang won't come back, what, as a last resort, do you go to?
Atlantic City.
Atlantic City. That's not quite what I had in mind. Where?
Atlantic City.
Where?
Atlantic City.
If all else.
Atlantic City. That's the only two words I learned. Atlantic City. A-L-L-A-N-D-I-C.
Believe me.
D-I-C-Y.
There'll be more fun when the commercial's done.
That's like a track star not being able to wear shoes.
But my mom's got nothing to do with it. So if you're confused about which one to use...
I'm afraid you've had it.
I like it.
All right, let's put it all together. Just exactly where do I stand?
You took a bath.
It was almost like a poker game. I understand you've decided to give up politics.
I was flat till I went fluffy.
I was flat till I went fluffy.
I was flat till I went fluffy. I was flat till I went fluffy.
News travels fast.
Well, all right, I'll go along with that. 10:03. It's 20 minutes after 9 o'clock. It's 26 minutes now before 10 o'clock.
9:04.
And good evening. It's 10 minutes after the hour of 9 o'clock.
Maggie's really done quite a job.
She was a drunk!
You have a dirty mind, Victoria.
Yeah, that's part of the reason why I wanted to talk to you.
Shame on you, Nancy.
I have half a dozen people on it, Senator, getting nowhere.
Shame on you, Nancy.
It is a snappy, tingly flavor.
Gives you a warm feeling inside, doesn't it? Rudy's my stepfather. He's your uncle. A grandma and a grandpa. And
maybe me and maybe you. You know what I'm talking about, Senator?
He says he's having the time of his life.
Shame on you, Nancy.
Aha!
Now listen, honey. A guy's hands need help, too.
Makes your mouth taste clean, not sweet.
And I don't smell like a flower. Shame on you, Nancy.
But my mom's got nothing to do with it.
Some of my best friends are women.
Tell me, Wild Man. Who's your friend?
Oh, Kuniwana, Wana Kunimana.
You're kidding. You mean you actually got married?
Oh, you could be Wana Kunimana.
And how's it feel to be a married man?
Oh, I got a little chair over there.
How long have you been married?
Oh, Kuniwana Kunimana.
2 days. Two days, I see. I should have known you were married when I saw the ring through your nose. Okay. Well, I see we're almost out of time. Can I ask you one final question? How can you tell the difference between a boy ape and a girl ape? I'm sorry. Does that mean you have to give back the gifts?
What's the problem?
It's disgusting.
What's disgusting?
No, that's the name of my pet. Disgusting Farkworth.
What kind of an animal is he?
A Brahma bull.
A Brahma bull? Wait a minute. Where in the world did you ever find a Brahma bull?
I found him to be very sick, that's all.
Well, just calm down, will you? Is his tongue red?
Yes, it is.
Do his ears flop?
Yes, they do.
Does he have a large hump on the middle of his back right about here?
Yeah.
Does he have fire in his eyes? And is he 2,000 pounds of muscle and meanness?
Yes, that's amazing.
Is he all white?
No, he's sick.
Oh, hi there. I'm Cheap.
And I'm Ashamed.
You should be. Tell them what our special is this week, Ashamed.
I'm ashamed to tell you that our special this week is Cling Peaches.
And I'm cheap enough to tell you that they're three for a dollar.
Did you ever wonder what Cling Peaches cling to?
No, I haven't. But say, have you tried our milk?
Is it fresh?
Is it fresh?
Oh, that's fresh. Oh.
That's fresh.
That's fresh.
You know, I just can't understand why I'm not calling any turkey, Artie. You know, this thing always worked for me before. And I have to get a turkey before the day's over. No doubt about it. Yeah, turkey, 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 turkey. Maybe I'm not calling right. You understand? What are you? What do you want? Can you look at this? Sit up here a minute. Will you look at this? This is White Rider, Rick Fox. He thinks it's Halloween. Does your mother know you're out? Does she know? Take it away, Slice, to you.
Sweet! Good afternoon, animal little. How you like a horse somebody picked up? Nice, 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 nice. You ask me what I'm going to do today? Good thing you ask. We got a banana with a skin. Watch out, this is very, very fast. Took me years of concentration and practice. And make sure you're not trying this at home with your bananas, because they're very expensive. About 19 cents a pound. You watch, observe. Watch, gonna throw a banana in there, watch. Oh, so, a banana of Mr. Connor, but a good friend, Artie Sokolsky, who pick up banana.
Ha, 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 you miss.
You think I missed, eh? I no miss. What? Well, wait. Just a moment. Yeah. You think a slice you miss? Slice you never miss. Because I so good. 1, 2, 3, 4. And a 5. You like that one?
All right, gang. Time for magic. I want you to watch very, very closely. Excuse me.
Your face. That's for me. I'm from the water company.
You're from the water company.
Testing your phone.
Testing the water company. I think it's working.
It works.
It works. Get out of here.
Where? Oh, hey. Can't make it. I mean, your face can't make it. Your face. Get over there, you mop. You. What? Get over there. Hey, you know that Kawasaki got a good saying. What was it I forgot to say? Oh, wait a minute. I've wrote some excuse me when I do this. I've written some resolutions down that I'm going to read to you right now. Oh, that's potent stuff, you know that? I promise not to call my mule face grandson mule face anymore. Yeah, mule face.
Okay, folks, I know you didn't ask for him, but here he is anyway. The greatest animal trainer of all time. Bring him back alive, Slater.
Hey. Ah, back you, baby.
Easy with that whip. I'm the animal, you dummy. What's the matter with you?
I heard different.
Oh, yeah. I understand you're going to demonstrate some animal training techniques for us. Is that right?
Does a warthog eat hot peppers?
Well, what kind of ferocious beast did you bring with you?
Well, actually, I couldn't bring my killer gorilla here because he goes bananas when he's on TV. Get it?
I get it.
But I did bring this ferocious monster here.
Hey, Slater, this is a stuffed animal.
That's okay.
See that? I mean, it's nothing more than a stuffed animal.
I know. It's my Fluffy. Isn't he cute?
He's adorable. What? Your nerves are steel by using a stuffed animal.
Yeah, I can use your imagination now, but if he was alive, I'd go, roll over, boy. Ha! Here's what he would do.
I'm going to help those plants of yours get potted. First, you grab your pot. Never let go of your pot, gang. Never let go. Pot. There. Be sure you've cleaned your potty, however, because there's nothing worse than having a dirty pot. Next, you need some seeds. And I don't have those seeds. We'll plant cotton. Only plant seeds of something that you want. For example, plant broccoli, for goodness sakes. Next, you cover your seeds. And just sit them in the sun.
Of course, if you're growing mushrooms, in which case, you don't have to put your seeds. You know, it's really a tragic thing. I don't know if you heard or not, but Lake Erie was totally polluted, killing all the fish in the lake. So the Fish and Game Commission of Canada imported the Klondike bass from Alaska. That was the only fish that could live in polluted waters. But it was a foul-tasting fish. No one liked the fish. So what they did, they bred the Klondike bass with a fish called the walleye pike. And they called that fish the kowal. Now, the kowal was a sweet-tasting fish, but it was a terrible fighting fish. None of the fishermen or sportsmen wanted to catch the fish because it gave no fight. So they crossed that fish with a muskie, and they called that fish the Kowalski. Now, they had a fantastically fighting fish on their hands, but they still had one problem. They had to teach it how to swim. Kowalski!
Zappo, the magical clown, you're going to do another trick.
Yes, I'm going to do another trick. Do you have a bag?
Do I have a bag? As a matter of fact, I just happen to have a brown paper bag. And
may I have it?
I think I'm going to need another one.
I'll try a little trick here. Watch it very carefully.
Very closely.
I'm going to blow up the bag.
Yes.
I'm going to pop it, and a live canary will appear.
A live canary.
Right, here we go. One, two, three. There it is.
Zappo the magical clown. Boy, they were the good old days. Oh, excuse me. I was just standing here reminiscing the old days. And old Shocky, I'll never forget the first time I ever saw Santa Claus. And I went to see Santa Claus to tell him what I wanted for Christmas. I think it was about back in 88, in the winter of 88 or 89.
Oh, ho, 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 ho. Merry Christmas to you too, Sonny. Who's next? Who's my
Hi,
next
I'm
little...
Santa Claus.
Oh, my goodness.
Hello, Santa Claus.
Hello there, young man.
How you doing?
Oh, I'm doing fine.
I'm done. Want a lick of my lollipop?
Oh, thank you. That was nice. What would you like for Christmas, little boy?
Oh, Santa Claus, good thing you asked me, because I need a new hammer.
A new hammer?
My desk was getting off the edges and everything. It's very, very weak, you know.
I'll see what I can do about that. What would you use a hammer for?
Oh, did I tell you?
No.
Oh, well, when I get one of the wise boys in the neighborhood, you know, uh-huh. They give me a hard time. I get him on a head like that. I said, go away, don't bother me no
more. Oh, well, that's very nice. I'll see if I can come up with something for you. No, thank you. What else would you like for Christmas?
Good thing you asked me, Santa Claus. Can you bring me two gross of rubber balloons.
Rubber balloons? Yeah. Oh, isn't that nice?
It's got water in it.
I see. It's awfully heavy.
They make neat bombs. You know, you fill with water and they go, whoosh, plow. Then it splatters all over you. You tell everybody all wet.
I'll talk to my elves about
it. Hey, you will.
I think I can be arranged.
You know what else I do with it?
No,
I get a pin like this.
I bust
it all over. Santa got wet panties. Santa got wet.
Oh,
I got a wet suit.
Yes, you do.
Yeah.
What else would you like?
Good thing you asked me, Santa Claus, because I need two cases of whipped cream.
That's cold. Two cases of whipped cream.
Two cases of whipped cream.
Why would you need two cases of whipped cream?
Because I make little pies out of this.
And
when somebody gives me hard time, I just go. All right, you try to. Wait a minute. Hold it. Stop.
Oh, my goodness. I think Santa's about to get a whipped cream pie in the face.
You're not playing fair now, Santa Claus. I don't like you no more. I ain't coming to see you no more.
Oh,
yeah.
Hit the
pipe. Dr. Shock always relied on his friends over the years. And it was these same friends who returned week after week after week just for the sake of a laugh.
Now you've got to have friends. You know the feeling's oh so strong. You've got to have friends to make that day last long. I had me some friends, but now they're gone. Something came and took them away. And from the dusk until where I'm gonna stay. Hey, well, I'll stand right. I don't care if I'm hungry or cold.
people who appeared on the shows over the years, thank you. And a special thanks goes to all of you faithful viewers who tuned in week after week. Dr. Shock wasn't the most famous star in the world. He wasn't the funniest man who ever walked the face of the earth. And he wasn't the greatest magician who ever lived. He was, however, a regular guy who shied away from the star treatment. A man who entertained us every Saturday for an entire decade. A man who enlightened the lives of all who knew him. He always gave much more than his share to charity and always left a smile where it was needed the most. He was a true gentleman and a great friend. But most of all, he was simply Joe Zawislak. And that was good enough. Thank you for watching.
If it's magic, then why can't it be everlasting? Like the sun that always shines, like the poet's endless rhyme, like the galaxies in time. If it's pleasing, then why can't it be never leaving? Like the day that, like on seashores, like the time that always tells, it holds the key to every heart throughout the universe. It fills you up without and quenches every thirst. Oh, if it's special, then with it why aren't we as careful? Making sure we dress in style, posing pictures with a smile, keeping danger from a child. It holds the key to every heart throughout the universe. It fills without a bite and quenches every thirst. So if it's magic, why can't we make it everlasting? Like the lifetime of the sun, it will leave no heart undone.